Hi, my name is Chris Vieira, and this is my quilt, Tiger Tiger. This quilt was designed for a quilt contest about 2-3 years ago, and the theme was optical illusions. And I knew that a lot of people were probably, or at least I thought that a lot of people were probably going to do, you know, your shape optical illusions, your black and white sort of stuff. And I wanted to go a little more outside the box. I've always been really fascinated with the pictures of, like, you know, do you see the lady or do you see the vase? Do you see the old lady or the hag, sort of the beautiful woman, those sort of ones. And so this is my version of that. There are actually 16 tigers hidden in this quilt. There's 6 in the applique and piecework and another 10 in the quilting. You have to kind of think a little outside the box to find them because not all of them are actual literal tigers. Some of them are more figurative tigers. For example, we have Tiger, T-I-G-E-R, in the quilting. Okay. The tiger himself is actually done with inktense pencils, and then he was appliqued on top of the quilt. I actually, kind of a funny story about this, and people will tell you you never do this with quilts, but you know, you got to make what works works. I made him twice. The first time I made him, I used the black inktense pencils, but what I didn't realize is that you have to get them wet to activate them and get the true color in, and I'm left-handed. And so as I was drawing, I was tracking just little itty bitty micro particles of black across all of this yellow, and they didn't show up until I got it wet. And so when I got it wet to activate it, I had all these little black marks in there. So when I made him again, I didn't want to make the same mistake twice, and I didn't want to make him a third time. So he's actually done with Sharpies to make all of the black, and it gives it a really nice, heavy-duty black color, but didn't have to worry about tracking any more of the inktints. The trees back here are also done with the same inktints. The rest of it is all a version of a needle-turned applique that I do on my sewing machine. I am incredibly impressed with anybody that does anything by hand, but I don't have the patience. I have a 14 and a 17-year-old in a full-time business, and so you may notice by the way I talk, I don't do slow real well. I try, but I don't. So let's see, what else can I tell you about it? Let's see. Oh, this is the one people probably have the most trouble finding, is the tiger in the tree. Although there is also a tiger in the tree, which you can see from further back and stuff. And I'm just really, really excited and happy that he gets to live here now.
Hi there, my name is Robert Worden. I'm a docent at the National Quilt Museum. I love that position, by the way. Now I'm here celebrating the 30th anniversary of our museum. I've got a quilt beside me by Chris Vieira called Tiger Tiger. The challenge is finding the 16 tigers. Let me divide those into 3 categories for you. The first one of my friends calls applique, but if you're a quilter, you know that may not be exactly correct. Notice the big tiger going across, the first one, and then look at the word tiger going down the body. That's 2. If you look right up there, you'll see face number 3, face number 4, next tiger's line 5, and some people, there's a hint, if it says don't lose it in the trees, there's the face of a tiger right there. So that's the first category of 6. The next two categories involve quilting per se. You're going to find the quilted body of the tiger several places throughout this, and the quilt word tiger several places through this quilt. So there's 5 bodies and 5 words to go along with the 6. 16 tigers are hidden in this quilt. Come and find them.